I'm just about to reveal how regular people make money on Amazon with little to no investment whatsoever, so let's get started. And just to be clear, the purpose of this video is providing you guys with a few different options, so you can choose the one you prefer and go for it. That being said, the first website I will need you to connect to is called Amazon Merch On Demand. And as the name of the website might suggest, this is a printing on demand service provided by Amazon.com. Here's how this works in a nutshell. The first thing you need to do is create a digital design that you think would sell. Once you've got that out of the way, and once that is done, and by the way, I'm going to help you with it, you get to upload your artwork onto Amazon, set the list price for the product you're going to sell, they print whatever gets sold, also facilitate fast shipping with Amazon Prime, and you get to earn monthly royalties. All of that with no upfront costs whatsoever. So that's why this is one of the more beginner-friendly options when it comes to making money on Amazon, because there's virtually zero upfront investment. Now, as you might expect, all of the process is already streamlined, and they've got the infrastructure to facilitate everything because we're talking about Amazon.com, which is a multi-billion dollar company. But here's the thing, even then, you're not really going to make any cash unless you have a pretty cool design that people genuinely want to purchase. So how do you do that? Now, I'm pretty sure that most of you, truthfully speaking, are not graphic designers or illustrators or artists. So if that's not the case, here's what I would personally do. Instead of trying to come up with some unique design myself and try my best at creating it, I would connect to a platform such as Vexels.com and get it done by a professional designer who knows what they are doing. So I would simply just submit my requirements, add all of the details, everything I would want within that design, and then their team of designers will make our ideas come to life and create these custom designs for our audience and niches. Long story short, you can literally describe exactly what you want to be created and their team of professional designers will have it done within a few days. So this is a no-brainer, especially if you're a beginner, especially if you lack the skill and the talent to do it, I would rather get it done by a professional. But now let's say that you don't really have a lot of ideas either, and instead you would simply want to copy a design and use that one. Well, you can do that as well. If you connect to Vexels and you head over to their print ready designs in the graphics section, you will find over 30,000 print ready vector designs for t-shirts and merch. And the thing about it is that once you download these designs, you are allowed to reuse them for commercial purposes, and nobody is going to sue you, nobody is going to have anything against it. However, if you want to make use of the platform and get access to all of these designs and to their professional designers, you do need to pay a monthly subscription that will cost you about, well, let's see, $22 a month. Or if you want to go for the Merch Plus subscription, that's $37 a month. And so all in all, this is pretty much the only investment you would need to make when it comes to printing on demand. And again, it is not necessary, but I would recommend that you get some help and don't just try some random designs yourself, because you may not be successful with that and you may just be losing your time. But guys, let's take it to the next level. Don't get me wrong, printing on demand can be quite profitable if done right, but that's a big if, because the success of this whole thing depends on your ability to create a design that people actually want to purchase. So you need to be a creative person, or at least try to understand trends and perhaps take advantage of that. So this is not something that anyone can do. And so if printing on demand doesn't sound right to you and you would like to try something else, well, Amazon FBA might be the solution. FBA here stands for Fulfillment by Amazon, and you're literally going to let these guys pick, pack, and ship your orders. All the while, you don't have to manufacture any product yourself, you don't even have to handle them. It's a no-brainer. Again, we're talking about a very beginner-friendly option. Here's how it works. The first thing you have to do is set up your account, and that is not too difficult. You have to create your Amazon selling account and then set up your FBA. Moving on, you get to submit your product listings. This is how you add products to the Amazon catalog. Then prepare your products and ship them over to Amazon's warehouses, where all of these Amazon employees will make sure to take care of your products, to store them in a safe space, and also ship them to your customer whenever you get an order, so you don't have to handle the product itself. And Amazon is going to deal with customer service, so you do not have to handle any annoyed customers on the phone. Amazon will do the dirty work for you. It's one of the biggest advantages when it comes to working with Amazon. You're literally letting them do all of the hard work while you get to keep a profit. But there are some very important things to keep in mind here. Not everyone can set up a successful Amazon FBA business, because there are so many things that go into it. Here's the thing, once again, when we're talking about the infrastructure, there is no doubt in my mind that that will be perfect, because we're talking about Amazon. So chances are everything is already set in place so that you can start the process. However, something that a lot of beginners struggle with is selecting the right products to sell. And this is where product research comes into play. Trying to understand the market, trying to understand customer behavior, and what generates all of these purchases. So here's what I would do. And in fact, this is what most successful sellers do. They connect to cheap suppliers such as AliExpress or Alibaba, where they can find all of these cheap products coming from China most of the times. And then you can implement a very similar process to dropshipping. But in this case, Amazon will help you out by giving you access to their warehouses so you can store your products there. They will also give you access to their shipping system, which is one of the fastest ones on earth. So it is literally dropshipping on steroids. But now when it comes to product selection, here's the biggest difficulty. What I'm gonna do right now is just take a look at some of these items on sale on AliExpress.com and pick one of them. Let's go for this bear right here. It's a pretty cool item. It's got a 98% discount, which is just insane. And we can literally purchase it for 11 cents, which makes selling it extremely easy and profitable. You can literally purchase it for 11 cents, and I'm not even kidding. It's a really cool product. It definitely has some functionality to it, so this is not just a toy. And I would certainly see this being bought by a lot of people. But here's the major drawback when it comes to both Amazon FBA and dropshipping. It's competition. Chances are you won't be the first one to sell this item on Amazon, and let me just illustrate that. I'm literally going to copy the name of this product, then I'm gonna connect to Amazon.com and search for it. And let's see if anyone else is already selling it on Amazon. Chances are there are people already selling this. I would bet money on that. Well, guys, I wasn't wrong. Over 1,000 results. And that just puts things in perspective. Now, something you're going to notice is that you don't necessarily have to be the first one to sell the product to make money. I mean, we've got a very popular listing here that's got over 1,200 reviews, but here's another one from a different seller that's made over 100 sales. And here's another one and another one, and I can keep on scrolling. Again, you don't necessarily have to be the first one to sell the product, but as you might expect, if competition is lower, then your chances of success are significantly higher. Apart from that, apart from being one of the first ones in the game, there's something else you can do, and that is sponsoring your content. You can pay Amazon a little bit extra to make sure that your product goes on top of the listing whenever people search for the product. And a lot of Amazon sellers are doing that, so they can promote their products a little bit further. But if you guys understand that competition is just a thing that you cannot simply run away from, it's always gonna be there. Everything else is really, really easy and streamlined. Let me show you a clear example of how the dumbest products on earth can literally sell thousands upon thousands of copies. And I'm not even kidding, I'm not exaggerating. Well, take a look at this Instagram page right here. It's got over 34,000 followers, and it was created for one single purpose, and that is promoting this product. And let me tell you, this is one of the dumbest products I've seen in a while. It's just a toy. It's got no functionality, but for some reason, people absolutely love it. And we can confirm that by taking a look at the engagement these videos are getting. I mean, this one right here has got 16,000 likes, probably hundreds of thousands of views. I mean, take a look at this. That's literally all it takes to get 16,000 likes with an Instagram reel. Just taping a watermelon to this toy and then throwing it. For some reason, people love that. And that's all it takes when it comes to marketing your product. If you get that much traffic, if you get that much attention to your products, then sales will not be a problem. Because what you can do is either list your product on Amazon or do something similar to what this seller has done, which is create your own e-commerce store using Shopify. Thus, you're implementing the dropshipping model and not Amazon FBA. But that's up to you. I personally prefer Amazon FBA because you're partnering up with the world's biggest marketplace, and there are so many advantages to that. No need for any storage space, they will handle customer service so you don't have to deal with annoying clients. It just makes things easier. But let's stick to the point here. Once again, these guys have basically put together a website where they're selling that product, they're probably outsourcing it from AliExpress or Alibaba, and they're making a lot of money in the process with very little effort. I mean, let's face it, is it that difficult to record these videos when you're just playing with a toy? You don't need any professional equipment for that. You just gotta keep on posting. And eventually, thanks to the algorithm, you might get a video that has 300 likes, but the very next one might get 37,000. That just goes to show that everyone can get a viral video without too much effort. And here's the thing, they didn't even have to be creative. They literally answered one of these popular comments. This is extremely fake, but you can get the idea. Guys, you literally have no excuses. If this seller can make thousands of dollars online selling this dumb toy, then you can certainly make money as well. But it all boils down to one thing, and that is product research. Browsing and browsing through all of these websites, through all of these marketplaces, looking for that one unique product that not a lot of other people are selling, but that is still good enough to be sold, that can generate this sort of impulsive purchase. Let's just imagine this scenario. Somebody is just scrolling through their Instagram Reels feed or their TikTok page, and they stumble upon your video. So they are going to watch it, they get entertained, and then they simply place an order because they think the product is great. That's what we're talking about. And you can leverage all of these social media platforms as well to generate traffic. It's absolutely free, and it might actually be more efficient than running paid ads. That's why I genuinely think that if you're still not making money on Amazon, it is your fault, because you've got all of these different options. You can set up your own clothing brand using Amazon Merch on Demand with virtually no upfront investments. You can set up an Amazon store. You can start selling items that you can buy for a very low price from China, and Amazon will take care of all of the dirty work. Or if you want to, you can even become an Amazon affiliate, where instead of selling your own products, you can actually sell someone else's products and still earn a commission. But I'm gonna leave that up to you. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.